start with the same thing I'm asking all these guys. Saturday night, was that the most fun you've ever had?
Oh, for sure. Definitely. It was definitely up there with one of the best games I've had, just as far as enjoying it, enjoying the crowd. They brought a lot of energy, so, you know, we were just loving it. And then, like, as far as just how our defense was playing, it was just fun to see, like, everybody doing well and playing well.
Now, obviously, when someone says Louisville, you think Lamar Jackson, but what do you know about Louisville's receivers and what kind of threat do they pose?
I definitely think they're going to, you know, bring a good, great energy as far as, like, their technique and how they, you know, I got a chance to watch them a little bit versus North Carolina, and they did a lot of good things, a lot of, you know, things that we're going to have to try to get on film and study on them and make sure that we be able to limit him and limit things that Lamar Jackson is going to be able to do. So I think the biggest thing is just, you know, making sure I'm getting the film room and starting to prepare on what the receivers are going
to
bring.
It looked like they tried to make him comfortable with a quick slant, quick throws out to the sideline. How difficult is that to defend?
Definitely. You know, you definitely have to have, like, the proper leverage, you know, certain formations. So that's why I feel like, you know, getting a good start on the film and, you know, seeing what they're going to be able to do with those type of slants and what type of formation that they'll be in. So I think the biggest thing is just making sure that, you know, we have the proper leverage if we're in a certain man call or a zone call that, you know, that we can make sure we limit those type of slants and underneath routes.
Austin had a great point over there. Y'all practice against Kelly Bryant, who is a dual threat quarterback, every day. How much does that help you going into a game against arguably the country's best?
It's definitely big because, you know, having going against Kelly Bryant, who can tuck the ball and run and scramble, you know, that definitely makes us, you know, ready for a type of Lamar Jackson. So, you know, I'm always say that we're not going to be overwhelmed by, you know, what we see because we have, you know, such great talent on the field here. So, I mean, it's big having to go against Kelly Bryant and just knowing that, you know, we can be able to limit him, I mean, limit Lamar Jackson just based off, like, what we see in practice every day.
Brian, what did these games with Louisville the last few years come down to the end?
Yeah, I mean, every game versus Louisville is big. You kind of just know beforehand the type of game that it's going to be. You know, it's just going to be one of those dog fights, you know, from first quarter to fourth quarter. So I think it's going to be really big for us to just, you know, prepare the way we've always prepared. And, yeah, it's going to be one of those games as always.
And I guess you can't take anything for granted. I mean, last year in the first half, the defense played Jackson and Louisville pretty well. Mm-hmm. And in the second half, he got going and made it one of those games. So you can't take anything for granted.
No, not at all. We can't take anything for granted. We just got to keep, you know, our foot on the gas from the first quarter to the fourth quarter, you know, make sure that we don't drop off if, you know, we start to get a good lead or anything of that nature. We just got to keep going. You know, whoever gets in the game, just keep bringing that mentality of, you know, we got to finish it, you know, 60 minutes or however long it takes to finish. So I think I'm really excited about the challenge and going against it.
Yeah, you guys know what you were going to do. You know what you did last week against Auburn, shut them down. People are talking about this defense now. Do you worry that maybe the offense still has to find its rhythm if you get into a 30-point game?
Definitely, but I feel like, you know, our offense is fine. You know, I feel like our defense, like you said, is playing really at a high level. It was great to see that, you know, versus Auburn, because I feel like we didn't get as big of a test against Kent State. So, you know, it was good to see that, you know, that and know that we can rely on our defense to make, you know, big plays and, you know, maybe keep us in the game if need be. But, I mean, I think, you know, we both work together, offense and defense. So, you know, I still enjoyed watching our offense play, and they played really well. So, I think, you know, going down later in the season that we both can rely on each other is what's going to be in special teams and what's going to matter the most.
Brian, last year Lamar had a lot of weapons around him that are no longer there. Who stands out to you the most this year?
I still have to get on the film a lot more, but I know that, you know, they have a good running back, number 7 and number 23. Their receiving core is definitely, they have skilled players. You know, I always say that, you know, when you play against teams, that everybody's skill is good. So it's kind of just making sure that I'm, you know, getting locked in on receivers and what they like to do out of certain sets and certain formations. So, you know, I was definitely going to, you know, start on that today and make sure, you know, I'm looking at the receivers, what they like to do, you know, as far as their releases and things like that. So I think the most, you know, maybe stand out just, you know, the receiving core.
Yeah. Defensively, do you almost have to set up a picket fence against him and then just make sure you stay in your part of the yard and not go chase?
Yes, definitely. We have to, you know, make sure we contain him. I think that's the biggest thing because, you know, he's great at scrambling. Even when you have a contained defense on, he still manages to, you know, find a way to get out and things of that nature. So I think, you know, we're just going to have to try to keep him in the pocket and, you know, try to make him, you know, beat us with his arm and, you know, throwing the ball because we know what he can do when he tucks it and runs it. So, yeah, I definitely feel like we're just going to have to, you know, make sure we have good contain and good defense on him.